Good morning, Integrity Music family. Corey Voss here, Madison Street Worship. So excited. I have my awesome friend Olivia Calderwood here with me this morning. And we are part of Madison Street Worship. And as you may or may not know or have seen on Facebook and Instagram and all over the place, we, our church family, we have a new record that's coming out called Songs of the House. And we've had three singles. This is our third single that we put out just yesterday called More Than Anything. And we are so excited about what God's doing in our church community. We're actually at our home church, Gateway Church in Shelbyville, Tennessee, right now. And I just wanted to take a minute and introduce Olivia to you guys. And we're just going to talk a little about the song More Than Anything on this project, Songs of the House. And yeah, Olivia, do you want to tell just a little bit about how we wrote this song and the heart behind it?
Yeah, so we actually wrote this song about a year ago. I think it was last January. I was finishing up an internship for my bachelor's degree and was doing it through Gateway. And so we got to sit down and write together. And we wrote a song that was, like, it was good. Like, we're like, oh, we wrote a song and kind of sat on it for a while.
It was like one of our first, right?
Yeah, it was. Yeah. I think it was the first song we actually wrote together. Yeah. And just kind of filed it away. Like, it was, you know, it was fine. But really wrote it from a place of remembering why we worship. And for the days and the moments that you're kind of, you come in distracted, or you come in depressed or downcast, or you just can't wrap your mind around, why should I praise God today? Just kind of a way to remember who God is, what God's done for us, how worthy he is of that praise, and what he gives to us. And it really, I think it's our heart behind this song, that it would lead you to respond to that gift that God's given us with a surrender of your own. Because everything he surrendered for us, it helps us to receive that and to offer him ourselves in return.
I love that. It's funny too, because in the song, like, the chorus says, "You are the lover of my soul." And I remember after we wrote it, like, kind of walking away from the song, part of me was like, is that, you know, that's something that you don't hear in worship songs as much anymore. But, you know, that's something that maybe in, like, the early 2000s, you heard that in a lot of worship songs. Jesus, lover of my soul, you know, all those songs. But it was cool to bring something like that back into a worship song. But the funny thing is that when we were in the process of recording this album, this is the song that we were like, I don't know, is this one gonna work? Is it gonna be?
Yeah, through a song.
Yeah, and then, like, our church family, they fell in love with it.
Yeah.
And then we led it for the first time, I think, the night of the recording.
Yeah, it was either that or it was, like, the Sunday before or something. Because there was, on our, like, going into the live recording, there was, you had made a, like, a set list. And there was a question mark in parentheses next to this song. I saw it. You know, I saw it, but I saw it. And I was like, yeah, I don't know either. And
so funny.
Yeah, about 3 days before, I think, we finally got rid of the question mark. But yeah, it was, we didn't really know about that
one. But here's the amazing part, is that the night of the live recording, there was, like, so many people that came up and they were like, what was that song, You Don't Owe Me Anything, Still You Give Me, what was that song? That's my song.
Which is so funny, because it was the bridge that threw us off, because it's not a true rhyme. So we were like, as technical songwriter people, we're like, I don't think that's good enough. It's anything, everything, everything, anything. Yeah. Doesn't rhyme. It's the same word. It's too much. Like, we really overanalyzed it. And it's so funny how God uses the things that we don't think are anything, the things that we wouldn't choose ourselves. He uses the things that are unexpected and even technically weak. Like, you could call that song lyrically, like, we thought that lyric was weak. And it's so funny because the Spirit of God just breathed on it and it became an anthem for so many people.
Yeah.
I love it.
Well, I'm excited, and we're going to lead this song for you guys, and it's our prayer as we sing this song that that you're encouraged and that you are filled with the love of God, and that you would just even encounter him as we lead. So, ready?
Stepped into time to render salvation. You gave your life for mine. King of all glory, throne to rescue the sinner and make this heart your home. You are the lover of my soul. You hold me close, you won't let go. All of my praise, my every song, Lord, you are worthy of it all. Father of healing, Spirit of hope, your mercy makes me whole. Oh, you are the lover of my soul. You hold me close, you won't let go. All of my praise, my every song, Lord, you are worthy. Still, you give me everything.
Awesome. Thank you guys so much for joining us. I'm just going to pray over all of us. And thank you, Olivia, for leading us. And that song is beautiful. And I'm just so thankful for songs like this because it brings us back to the heart of worship. It brings us back to the center. And it lets all the exterior things just kind of get out of the picture. So do you actually want to pray over everybody before we go?
Absolutely.
Awesome.
Lord, I pray over the weary hearts this morning that we would be reminded of who you are. Oh, that we would be drawn into the greater arc of your love for us, God, that's eternal. That was before we were born, and that's going to be after we're done in this life, Lord. Would you just draw us into a deeper response to who you are so that we can receive more of what you are literally dying to give us? Lord, bring those who are too much in their heads into their hearts, Lord, and speak truth over those who are confused and who are too caught up in their emotions. Remind us who you are and what you've done, and teach us to be free in that identity of who you're inviting us to be through that. And we thank you for that opportunity, and it's in your name we pray. Amen.
Awesome. Have a beautiful Saturday, everybody. Thank you so much. Our record comes out next week. Songs of the House, Madison Street Worship, and More Than Anything just dropped yesterday on iTunes, Spotify, all of that. I think we posted a smart link on this post. So God bless. Have a great day.